Hey there.
Could use some hair of the hound. Got any vodka?
There you are.
See the hollyhock there? The violet blooms. Brought the plants here from Nazaire. Anna had read some story, insisted on having them. Spent hours tending to them, trimming, pruning. She was so content at that. And them, the frilly ones, called birds of paradise in Zerikania. But Tamara called them dragons of paradise. She adored them. Damn shame I'll never learn which blooms would please Daya most. Though it's good to know her spirit's free.
Your loss, it must hurt bad. But there wasn't anything we could do.
No. Not now. Not anymore. It was too late. That was clear. Should have acted earlier. Taken them all from this damned villain. In this hole. This reasty mire. Nothing could go right here.
Got some information about your family.
You've learned something? Well, let's go inside. It's a bit chilly out. Any news for me?
Your daughter's in Oxenfurt.
What the blazes? She all right? In good health? Safe? Why haven't you brought her back?
Never offered to do that.
How do you know she's safe? You see her at least?
No, but I talked to the man who helped her escape and then took her in. Tamara is safe and sound. From what I gathered, she has no desire to see you again, no intention to return.
I shan't trust some peasant dolt. I shan't trust whoever it has helped her. I need to know for certain she's safe. Go to her. You must be sure. See her yourself. I shan't believe anyone else.
That much I can do.
I'm grateful. Take this. Call it enticement. And this might prove useful.
What is it?
A letter of safe conduct. Ever since the Redanians took hold of the Pontar Delta, they made it damned hard to get to Novigrad without one. Very well. You were to find them both. What of Anna? Learned anything?
Nothing yet, but I'm on her trail.
Well, what are you waiting for?
For you to tell me about Ciri, like we agreed.
Fine. A word once given. When Ciri was on the mend, we took her out on a hunt. Thought a bit of galloping would warm up her limbs gone stiff from so much bed rest. That lass of yours, pure luck in the flesh. To hunt down a wild boar that size, why, worthy of one of King Faltest feasts, were he still among the living. Ciri, come! Our haunt should be yours as I see it.
Oh, you're doing well, lass.
Not bad. Not bad at all. But who goes boar hunting with a sword?
No bow at hand, no spear. My sword was all I had.
Well, you brandished it beautifully. Where'd they teach you that, anyway?
A little here, a little there.
Not surprising, given you wander the world alone.
Not alone no more. She's in the company now.
That's right. You're a member of the company. We're drinking together, killed a wild boar as a pack, you might say. But we've no notion how you arrived here. A woman in a man's garb, razor on her back. Who exactly are you? You a mercenary?
I just travel a lot, and I don't always happen upon such good and civil company.
Ah, gift of the gab she's got. Here's to good company.
This I like. Drinks like a lad, knows her sword work, kills a boar as if it were a piglet. A she-wolf, if ever I've seen one.
All right, all right. A woman could swing a sword, I've knowed one, but never seen a lady mount anything but a cock proper. All tipsy on horseback, nothing strange on account they bloody mount them sideways.
Perhaps you'd care to wager?
Think you can outrun me on an horse? Naturally. What's the stake?
Black mare. The one in the stable.
Oh, that won't do at all.
Well, that's an awfully gloomy face. Too much of a coward to race a woman.
The horse is mine.
To race the Baron himself, I'd consider it an honor.
Oh, that'd be a sight to behold.
Would it ever?
Done. But if I win, I take your sword.
Agreed.
I'd not drink any more this night. You'll want your head about you. We start at daybreak. The day dawns.
Ready?
As ever. First one to the tower.
Mount up! Come on, Siri, don't you embarrass us!
Go on!
Want that horse, don't ya?
Had one just like it!
You're wind, not woman. Worthy of the best horse. The mare is yours.
Thank you.
What?
Another chance to win.
She screamed like a mad woman. In an instant, all had forgotten the wager. Every man ran to save his skin, even were he to break his neck.
And they make it?
Some, aye. Others were not so fortunate. But what happened then? I must say, Witcher, seen a lot, but nothing like this. Never.
Uh-oh. I know that look.
You're a fast learner. You'll know the rest once you find my wife.
Working on it.
And making piss-poor progress.
They split up. Hadn't considered that possibility before. But don't worry. I'll find Anna, too. So long.
Last night, too.
Wait, Witcher! When you find my daughter, will you give her this?
A rag doll.
Boys say there's a last round one of the villages that'll let you poke her for a few scraps.
Redania.
honor and the fatherland.
Got a pass.
You don't need a pass. We're from Novigrad, 8 generations and more. The Warcroft is in the Zima.
No passage!
No passage.
Whoa!
Halt! No passage.
Case of the plague surface in the city or something?
The plague? No. We're to not let folk in the city. It's an order, so I don't, unless someone's got a pass.
This what you mean?
Let me look at that. Missing a seal. The red one.
Impossible.
Department of Civil Defense forgot again. They're really off their heads these days. Happens, so be it. You may come through.
Come through.
Come on.
What the devil?
What is that?
Whoa there, Roach.
Halt! You there? Please wait! You're Geralt of Rivia, are you not?
Depends who's asking.
Revenue and customs for occupied Temeria, Dorian branch. Represented by yours truly, Deputy Tax Enumerator Walter Mormitti.
Honored, I guess. What seems to be the problem?
In brief, undeclared income.
Excuse me?
We've had reports, numerous, that over the last months you've come into a great deal of coin. Quickly. So quickly it's raised suspicions.
Don't you have anything better to do?
Not at the moment. Make no mistake. You cannot evade this. You must answer my questions promptly and in full. Profession?
Witcher. Monster Slayer.
Sole proprietorship. Service sector. Type of services rendered. Rat, pest, monster removal. Moving on. Have you at any time engaged in the wholesale trade of rawhide in the White Orchard area?
Might have. Once or twice. Definitely no more than 3 times.
And did you then file a WIPT 30/C form with the Revenue and Customs Office for your place of residence? No? As I thought. Right. Next. During the current fiscal year, have you engaged in the acquisition of bivalves with the express intention of selling the pearls therein?
Even if I have, what's wrong with that?
Article 86, Section 3 of the Tax Code. Whosoever purchases goods at an unseemly low price to take advantage of the seller's ignorance shall be subject to a fine equaling 200% of the earnings from any such a transaction. Sound familiar? And now, please answer. Have you or have you not dealt in said pearls?
No, never done anything of the sort. Witcher's honor.
Now, for the final question. Have you ever unlawfully acquired another man's movable goods? Chattels.
Meaning?
Meaning? Have you ever waltzed into someone's home and taken something without their permission?
Gotta be kidding. The Witcher's Code forbids it.
I'm pleased to hear you abide by your guild's bylaws. Now, if you could wait for one moment. Compare column B to table 7. Apply the rate for confirmed childless bachelors. A tax credit of 7.3% for practitioners of hazardous professions. It adds up to the crown. I say, good sir, you are exceptionally upstanding.
It'd be rude to disagree.
in these times, such civic virtue is a rarity. It must be commended, rewarded. Here.
What? What's this?
A diploma. I bestow on you the title of taxpayer in good standing. I'd suggest you frame it. Hang it in a place of honour. Congratulations.
I'm looking for Tamara, the Bloody Baron's daughter. Your brother said I'd find her here.
Wojtek sent you, sir.
How else would I know she was here?
Wait a moment. I'll fetch her straight away.
Might you be? My father send you?
Yeah, to see if you're still alive and well. I'm Geralt of Rivia.
I'm quite alive and extraordinarily well, Geralt of Rivia. Better than I've ever been in this rotten life of mine, and now that you've seen me, I bid you farewell.
Wait.
We've nothing more to talk about.
Got every right to be angry at your father, but he's worried about you.
I have a right. Thank you kindly. So good to have the approval of his hired thug. And my father worries only about what to get soused on next.
He's no saint, that's clear. But he's got the whole province on its feet looking for you. Finding you and your mother? Seems to me there's nothing more important to him now. I know evil men. He's not one of them.
Shame he never showed such concern before. Especially for my mother.
He made a mistake and knows that. I'm not defending him, just saying that maybe he's come to realize what he's done and what you mean to him.
Oh, wonderful. I'll bear that in mind. Did you really come all the way here just to tell me that?
Before I agreed to look for you, your father told me his version of events. Tell me yours.
Mine? It's dull as life amidst the swamps. My earliest memories are of a drunken father lying under the stairs, caked in mud and clutching a bottle. Next dozen years, pretty much the same. Father would drink, disappear for days, then come home in a rage and send furniture flying. Thank the gods for war. I was glad every time they sent him off. And the quarrels. I remember him screaming at Mum, the thuds as he beat her, then her sobbing. I'd hide under my bed and long for silence. That's the long and short of it. Multiply by 19 and there you have my life. Finally, we'd had enough, Mum and me. He crossed the line and we fled.
Wojtek claims your mother had strange marks on her hands and that a monster dragged her into the woods. That true?
We were riding towards the river. Suddenly, Mum cried out, bent over, almost fell off her horse. I rode up to her and saw something strange. Her hands were on fire. And then that creature leapt from the woods. I don't know what it was, but it roared so fierce my nose bled. I saw it topple trees. I've never been so scared in my life. And that thing grabbed my mum and disappeared into the woods. I wanted to turn back, go after them, but the horses panicked. Now I don't even know if she's alive.
I don't mean to pry, but I know your mother had a miscarriage.
His doing? He shoved her, she fell, that's how it started. We were alone, no one to help, blood everywhere. Worst night of my life.
Sorry. Must have been hard for you both.
Mum was in shock. She was raving that it was better this way, that she never wanted the child. Must have had a fever, she was losing blood the whole time.
She didn't want the child?
Said she'd sooner cut open her gut than bear another child from his seed.
What will you do now?
Find my mum.
You realize that might not be that easy.
Don't worry, I'm not daft enough to believe I can do it alone. I've got some new friends now. Powerful friends. They'll help me.
What about your father?
Who? Oh, him. I don't care. I won't go back to him. That bit of my life, forgotten it already.
Who are these friends, if it's not a secret?
No secret. Heard of the Church of the Eternal Fire? A priest helped me contact the Redanian witch hunters. Righteous, brave men. They'll help me.
Well, well. A witcher. Never thought the Baron would stoop to hiring a monster slayer. Though I hear you're good at tracking things down.
Glad you know who I am. Haven't introduced yourself, though.
Graden. Witch hunter in the service of His Royal Majesty Radovid of Redania. I'm certain you've heard of us.
Rings a bell.
If the bloody Baron sent you to fetch his daughter, you'd best face it. You will fail in your task.
I appreciate your concern, but I don't need it. As for Tamora, she can make her own decisions.
Noble of you. A killer for hire, abandoning his bounty for the good of another. The hunters and the Church of the Eternal Fire thank you. So the Baron hired a witcher to find his daughter. Interesting.
Where are you going to take her?
Tamora must rest. She's had a harrowing experience. When the warmth of the Eternal Fire has restored her strength, we shall see about finding her mother.
Before you go, your father asked me to give you this.
Clara? Father told you to give me Clara. Funny how he thought to buy me back with a memory. Tell him one gesture could never make up for a ruined childhood. So long, Witcher. In spite of all, I'm grateful you gave me a choice. Didn't force me to go back to the tyrant.
Hope you know what you're getting yourself into. So long, and good luck.
I'm listening. What do you come to me with?
Gave Tamora your gift.
How'd she react?
Probably not like you'd have wanted. She threw the doll away.
Threw it away? Oh, gods, I hoped, despite all. Well, what of Anna?
Still don't know anything specific, but I'm on her trail.
Well, will you stand there like a knob? Find her!
So long.
Sight.
Doug went in the kitchen, stole a hunk of meat. Cook gave him a licking, strung him by his feet.
Cook then bled him empty, stripped his skin off clean.
Laughed and said how tasty, best sausage I have seen.
Cook's a stupid killer, shouldn't have ate the pup.
Now we'll light a fire, gonna roast him up. 1, 2, 3, the one to fetch the kindlings, thee!
Interesting rhyme.
Don't know you, go away.
What are you doing out here alone?
We's not alone. We's with Gran.
But where did you all come from?
We's orphans.
All of you?
There's a war, so there's orphans. Didn't know that.
A young woman got lost in the swamp. She has ashen hair and a scar on her face. You kids see anyone like that?
Ain't no lassies here. What am I?
You're no lassie. Lassies got tits.
They do. Heard an old man say once, when the army was here, he says, hide them lasses in the woods. They's dazzling the soldiers with their tits. And it's torturing the poor lads. That's what he said.
Anyone else here, besides you?
Meaning who?
Someone who might have seen the woman.
Like the six-eyed tree?
Tree slapped all year. But there is Johnny.
What's this talk? What kind of jabbering is this, eh? No one allowed here. Just kids. My kids. They're allowed. But who are you, wearing swords like a bandit?
You look after these kids?
They're my grandchildren.
Gran's good to us. Gonna be soup with scratchings for supper.
Kids get lost in the woods. I miss them. Seen them in the woods? No one has.
Just talking to the kids. Asked them if they'd seen a young woman.
Oh, I was a lovely young woman. Wore a long, beautiful braid my mummy did up for me. Had dresses with flowers on them.
Maybe you've seen her. Young, ashen hair.
Your betrothed?
Daughter, actually.
Daughter? My dear, sweet little daughter and her sister. Where are they now? Maybe they've come to some harm?
A bit of help, please. A young, ashen-haired woman. Just need to know if you've seen her.
What are you looking at, children? Wash your hands, we'll go catch crickets.
Won't learn anything from you.
Aye, because I don't know nothing.
That Johnny knows. He knows a lot. When I ask him something, he says, wait, I'll scratch my arse and tell you.
Ugly word. What you saying? To the hut. You'll stand in the corner. I'll make sure you do. You, be gone. Be gone! Come in here. Not allowed in here.
I just want to talk to the boy.
Not allowed. It's not allowed.
He won't talk to you anyway. Gran don't like you. And Johnny's made up. And strangers steal kids.
Just got one question for you.
Don't be asking no questions. You're a stranger. Not allowed to talk to strangers.
Now, suit with scratchings.
You hear? Says he's afeard of you. Stop scaring my kids.
Ow!
Why don't you want to talk about Johnny? One of you knows about him. The others must too.
It's just him who's pals with Johnny. They pick mushrooms and hunt snails. But Gran says Johnny's made up.
Have any of you ever seen Johnny?
Of course. Looks just like him.
Then why do you say he's made up?
Gran says so. And Gran knows lots.
Does your Gran treat you right? She ever hurt you?
Never.
When we're bad, she cries.
She's scared. Says strangers might take us. And we'll disappear.
The boy who plays with Johnny, he must be brave.
Not brave, just stupid.
Sat his bare bum on an anthill once. But yeah, he plays with Johnny. He don't listen to Gran and goes in the woods, and then he's got to have a time out.
And he eats snails. Yuck.
The girl I mentioned is in danger. You gotta help me get your Gran away from the hut so I can talk to Johnny's friend.
All right. But you've got to do something for us, too. Play hide and seek. Gran never does. Says her feet hurt.
Let's play. You hide, but if I find you, you have to help me talk to the boy who knows Johnny.
He thinks he'll find us easy.
Means he's never hid from the black ones.
No looking, and you have to count out loud. All your fingers, toes, too.
One, two, three, 18, 19, 20. Ready or not, here I come. See you. Come out.
How'd you find me?
Found you. You can stop hiding.
No fair. I'm supposed to win.
There you are. Guess that's everyone. Found you all.
You don't play right. But we'll help. Come on, let's talk to the others by the cottage.
Found you all. Now you gotta keep your word and help me talk to Johnny's friend.
Why wouldn't we? Promised, didn't we?
Don't be afraid.
don't know nothing.
I won't hurt you.
Where's Gran?
She's busy. Why are you scared to talk?
I'm not scared of nothing.
You're all scared of something. Would have told me about Johnny otherwise.
I'm worried about Johnny. He don't come around no more. Once, when we was mushroom picking, I saw his burrow. But Gran yelled at me. Said not to talk to strangers, cause then kids go missing. She worries about Johnny too, though she says he's made up.
I just want to talk to Johnny. He could know more than you.
Not gonna hurt him, right? Cause he's real. He's not made up.
I'm not gonna hurt him.
Johnny used to be boy, cause Gran liked listening to his songs. When we was picking mushrooms, Johnny said he saw a girl with ashen hair in the swamp.
Where can I find Johnny?
There is a little meadow on the edge of the swamp. This strange tree grows there. Look around. You'll see him.
Thank you. Lead to a burrow. Wonder what's inside. Johnny? Don't be afraid. You're a bucka? A lutin? Ah, a godling. Not many of you left. I'm looking for a woman with ashen hair. Seen her? Tell me everything, from the start. Where did you see her? What was she doing? It's important to me. Why not? What's wrong? Can't talk? Why? Lost your voice? Can I help you somehow? Want me to follow you? No choice, I guess. Damn it. Stay close to me. This the place? Let me look around. Something's on the ledge? Something that'll get you your voice back? Ah, the bottle from the nest. Already got it. Here.
By the Pontar.
Done celebrating?
My favorite words! Life without savoring the sound of surreptitious shenanigans is like licking snails through a cloth. Thank you for this, noble whoever you are. Long be your life.
Hang on a minute. I helped you, now you help me.
Would you turn this beautiful act of altruism into a banal bartering of favors?
How'd you lose your voice?
One morning I awoke and opened my mouth for my usual bout of singing with the thrushes. Lo and behold, no sound escaped. I tried and tried, almost burst a blood vessel. Then I went to the village, because word has it, the new cunning woman works miracles. But people began crying out, "A smudger! A smudger!" and sick their dogs on me. Do I look like a smudger to you?
Not a bit.
I thought not. So it must be the crone's doing. Who else would curse me? Blackbird friend of mine located my voice, but I was helpless to retrieve it.
Couldn't ask a raven friend to just give you the bottle?
Ravens serve the crones. They don't help no one.
I'm looking for a young, ashen-haired woman. See anyone like that?
Did I ever? Remember it as if it were yesterday. Soon as I woke, I went to empty my bowels, my favorite part of the day. Defecating to the sunrise, downright glorious. Suddenly, heard a bang, so loud it couldn't have been me. And that lass appeared, out of nowhere. Young, ashen-haired, just like you said. Wounded, panting to boot. She raced off towards the children's huts, quick as if the crones were after her. I yelled some unpleasantries. She disturbed my mourn. Sadly, I'd lost my voice, so I don't think she heard me.
I've been to the village in the swamp, met a woman who might have been a crone.
Did she seem confused to you?
Nuts, completely.
So I'm not crazy. That's no crone. That's the granny who takes care of the orphans. Claims the kids made me up. Me!
An orphanage in a swamp?
What do you have against swamps? Lived here my whole life, and I heartily recommend it.
What do you know about the crones?
They're as old as this forest. Cruel, vindictive, not to be crossed.
What if someone does cross them?
Might take his voice, might take his life. Depends on their whim. They're nasty, although they care for this land and its folk in their own way. Supposedly, they always keep their word, but you must be careful what you ask for. Won't find them until they want to be found. See them until they want to be seen. But remember, they see and hear all that happens in the mire.
She ran off toward the orphanage. Kids could know something, or the old woman who takes care of them.
Oh, that old hag don't speak to strangers. And you're a stranger.
Will she talk to you?
I have spoken to her, got my ways. So be it. You helped me and I'm no bore. Come with me.
Watch out!
Watch out!
Good. It's clear. Not a crone in sight. I need to sing to Gran. That ought to calm her.
Little Johnny softly gazed, fire waning pale. Pop! A spark jumped out and whispered, "Listen, I've a tale."
You got your voice back.
I did, though I seem to have lost an octave somewhere in the process. I shall look for it when I get home.
You're not allowed here, Johnny. You shouldn't have come.
Calm down, Gran. Don't get angry. It's not good for you.
The woman I asked about earlier.
Forgive me, Gran, but this fellow absolutely must talk to the ladies.
No. She's not allowed.
Please, it's important.
The fellow will be quiet. Gran, please hear me out. I found little Yagna when she got lost, did I not? Did I break Ginny's fever too? I did. I ask anything in return? No. Didn't even fuss about my stolen voice. Well, now I want something. Gran, help this fellow. Because otherwise he'll pester me day and night, even during potty time. His lass is missing. Perhaps the ladies can help find her, eh?
Well, since you put it that way, Johnny, I'll help him. Come with me. Johnny's a good lad. Though the ladies don't like him. No. Foul creature, they say. Don't like him.
Who are the women in the tapestry?
Those are the ladies. Ladies lovely, with power o'er all, beseech I thee. Answer my call. Before you a worm crawls, wretched and small.
How dare you disturb our rest, woman?
I'm looking for the woman with ashen hair. I know you met her. Where is she?
Oh, he's impatient. Perhaps he only likes ashen-haired girls.
It's clear you met her. Tell me everything.
That was blunt. Well, perhaps it's for the best. Tell me, have you got bollocks? Do you fear woodland beasts?
Oh, hard times are upon this white-haired one. Brother has turned against brother. The land is soaked in blood. Evil reigns stronger than ever before.
A dark power has surfaced near Dunwarren. It feeds on hatred and disdain. Destroy the beast, and we will be grateful. Tell you all we know about this ashen-haired maid.
Dark power? You need a knight errant, or a witch hunter, not a witcher.
The alderman of Dunwarren will tell you all. Remember to collect payment from him after you complete your task. And now our servant will bring you the dagger.
A dagger? What for?
When the alderman sees this dagger, he'll know we sent you. He'll aid with all.
I'll talk to the alderman, but I can't promise anything.
Move, woman! Give the young man the dagger.
And you, white one,
Return only once you've completed the task.
Aye, mistress, right. On me way. Dagger. Gotta bring the dagger. The dagger. For you. Lady told me to give it you. Here it is. The dagger. Place the alderman's payment on the stone. Stone bear, stone shear, stone nose, stone ears.